Hey folks, Emeril Lagasse here with my girl Peyton, and you're watching WMBB 13.
We have an exclusive first look into what's to come. Stay tuned.
Bam.
On Thanksgiving Day, the nation got a dose of Louisiana flavor at the Macy's Parade in New York with a celebration gator float. Now that flavor is heading to the West Coast with a float in the annual Rose Parade in Pasadena, California. Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser is here with us this morning. Good morning.
Good
Thanks
morning.
For being here. Kind of tell us a little sneak peek of what people are going to get to see New Year's Day.
Well, it's going to be 34,000 roses.
Welcome back. The time now is 6:12. The Vietnamese Lunar New Year is next Tuesday, but one local school is getting the celebration going early. Bill Wood is live at the International High School in New Orleans with more. Good morning, Bill. And happy Mardi Gras, guys. I am so thrilled to be here with you for another Mardi Gras. This is such a spectacular day. We have all of the who's who are out here waiting to see that Rex rolls. And in fact, we have a matriarch of New Orleans, a true Mardi Gras lover. We have Miss Gail Benson here with us this morning. Miss Gail, you have loved Mardi Gras since you were a young child. Tell us one of your favorite memories about Mardi Gras.
Well, you know, I grew up on the U.S. Bank in Algiers, so we used to go on Opelousa Street and watch all the parades. And so it was just such a thrill for me. We'd dress up, and it was just always such a thrill.
You have a deep love for the city and something that I think connects to the motto of Rex, the pro bono publico. You hold that, the common good, the good for the public. How does that relate to the Saints and what you do for the city?
You know, since I grew up here, I feel like we should always help the city and give back.
Now, the Smoothie King Center may be empty right now, except for the Spurs, who are gearing up right now. But in less than 2 hours, fans will be flooding in here to see the return of Zion Williamson. Now, there's a lot of hype and anticipation surrounding this game that's been growing for quite a long time. After missing the first 44 games, a lot of fans are ready to see him on the court. It's been 3 months to the day from when Zion was supposed to make his NBA debut, but a lateral meniscus tear stopped him in his tracks. The first thought was he was going to be out for 6 to 8 weeks, and Zion will take the court as the Pelicans rookie forward tonight playing against the Spurs. We are anticipating that he's going to be ready to go. He said that he's been meditating on the sidelines, gearing up for the games, but he did say that he was a little worried because he wasn't sure if he was going to get any sleep the night before. So I'm curious to see if he's going to be awake on this court, ready to take home that W. The tip-off is going to be tonight at 8:30. We'll be here. We'll have another look later. It is looking great out here, Tamika and Seth. You know, yesterday was the Pro-Am, and today is the official start of the Zurich Classic. Golfers took to the course at 7 a.m. to take a swing at the Zurich Classic. And today, we're going to see 5 of the 6 top golfers in the world all playing right here at the TPC in Avondale. Now, take a look at these greens. These greens are looking luscious, and it's taken weeks for the TPC managers to get these looking so great and ready for the tournament. They are making each hole competitive and challenging for all of these golfers. And right now we're over on the 17th hole, where you can see spectators have been waiting patiently for the golfers to make it to this hole. And it has been such a beautiful day out here. The sun is shining. It's not as windy as it has been over the past couple of days. The 2022 Zurich Classic winning team will get a record purse of $8.3 million. The Zurich Classic is the only team tournament in the PGA Tour season. And we're going to see, like I said, some of the world's best golfers playing right here this weekend. And this competition is going to be going on for the next couple of days. So if you haven't gotten your tickets and you haven't been able to get out here, you still do have some time. It's going to be going on throughout the weekend, and Sunday is going to be the day when they announce who's going to be the winner of the Zurich Classic. So go ahead, get your tickets, grab the sunscreen, grab some sunglasses, and get out here. It's going to be a great weekend to be on the golf course. I'm Peyton Trist, reporting live from the Zurich Classic, WGNO News. Both teams, the Saints and the Dallas Cowboys, are coming off of a Week 12 loss and several obstacles to overcome in order to get a win tonight. For the Dallas Cowboys, their head coach is out due to COVID protocols. And for the Saints, several key players are still on that injury report. Now, the Saints have a record of 5-6, and the Dallas Cowboys are 7-4. All right, we're here. We're trying to break a world record for line dancing. What do you think, ladies? You think we can do it?
Yay!
All right, stay tuned. We're going to have more a little bit later.
She's a Scripps Spelling Bee winner, as well as a Guinness World Record holder. And now this girl from Harvey gets to add one more title to her name. Zaila Avantgarde.
What a weekend, Tamika and Seth. You know, the final four games over the past couple of days have had some intense moments and some great matchups, especially on Saturday with the game between Duke and North Carolina. It was a nail biter, but we are just hours away from finding out who the next national champions are going to be. Who will it be? Is it going to be Kansas or is it going to be North Carolina?
I bet you guys cannot guess exactly where I am. Can you see it? I'm at the very high school stadium where Coach Ed Ogeron played high school football. I'm at South Lafourche High School, and we are so excited because we got to learn a little bit more about who Coach O is, and we learned around in these parts, he goes by the name Bebe.
Bebe was in my first grade class, and Albon, man, I knew Bebe almost as long as my parents, man. And we were real close.
Winning several awards and making All-State player when in high school, Coach O is a living legend in the halls at South Lafourche High School.
And it started in high school and getting to where he's at now. It's unbelievable, you know. And I say unbelievable, but it is believable knowing the type of person to be.
But later down the road, there were a few blocks on the football field.
I got to know Coach O when he left Miami. And he came back here and he was out of football for a while.
After a long hiatus, Coach O wanted back in the game. Helping get Ogeron back in, LaFont went to the coach at Nicholls State and got him a volunteer coaching position at the school.
And the door opened up and Bebe comes out and he grabs, "Hey, I got a job!" I don't think he's ever forgotten how I played a small part in him getting back in. He loves his players, he loves his community, he loves his family. What you see is what you get.
We just heard that Monday has officially been declared Coach O Day by the Lafourche Parish President. Some fans are on their way to a celebration brunch in the quarter, while others, well, you know that saying, party till the sun comes up? There's a couple of LSU fans who are living that truth this morning and still letting the good times roll.
Last night's game was a nail-biter during the first half, but LSU got the last laugh in the Superdome. With the 42-25 score, fans flooded out of the dome and going right from the bleachers to Bourbon. While some will probably be nursing their hangovers this morning, others are hitting the road.
Well, we partied in the streets with everybody. Number one, but we weren't surprised. We knew this was going to happen all year long. It was kind of like a calling.
Well, you know, we started drinking about 1 o'clock yesterday and partying with everybody. Clemson fans were pretty cool. We're getting along with them, and just again, like I said, it was expected. We didn't even when we got behind. We weren't worried. We were just waiting for it to come back, and we did, and won a national championship.
It's a big day for New Orleans with big announcements being made here in the Superdome. We're just 54 days from the big game, and there's a lot that's going to be happening.
Let the countdown begin, sparing no expense and getting the hottest names in music right now. The 2020 College Football Playoff National Championship is rolling out the red carpet in New Orleans. The star-studded event will bring in free performances by Tim McGraw, Meghan Trainor, Trombone Shorty in Orleans Avenue, Her, Bastille, Nas, Judah and the Lion, and Max. The national anthem will be sang by one of Louisiana's own, Lauren Daigle. And you know it's a good lineup when Rachel Lindsay, a former bachelorette, is excited.
So every year I'm like a kid in a candy shop. I say, don't tell me who the lineup's going to be for AT&T Playoff Playlist Live. I want to find out when everyone else does. So I'm sitting there like tapping my foot to the music. I'm like, okay, Nas, Her, Tim McGraw. People don't know I'm a country music fan. So I'm like, Tim McGraw is bringing out something in me. I can't wait to put on my boots and my hat. Did you hear the country come out? I said boots.
Down below us is where the All-State Sugar Bowl Fan Fest is happening. And I was out there earlier today, and the festivities are absolutely incredible.
Oh, yeah.
Just now, Sheryl Crow took the stage, and everyone was so excited because she had a lot of all of her hits that she sang. It was awesome. But One of our personal favorites was our local favorite artist, Amanda Shaw.
Our friend.
Yes, she was amazing. She was so great. But everybody's waiting for Usher. He will be on any minute now. And there are thousands of people who are down in that area waiting for the countdown to begin. So we're really excited. There's lots to do. And everyone's gearing up for the big game tomorrow, the Sugar Bowl. So there's a lot to be excited for because we're getting close to the new year.
Good morning. I'm Peyton LoCicero-Trist. New Orleans police are investigating an overnight shooting that left one man dead in St. Rock. It happened around 11:30 last night. A lot of people are starting to worry knowing that a Category 4 could hit this area. How are you feeling? Any words of advice for those who are considering riding the storm out or on the fence of leaving?
You need to leave.
Linemen are working sun up to sun down to restore power in the river parishes. But unfortunately, most of the homes here in Luling are still in the dark, and it's been almost 12 days without power.
Hey guys, I'm over here this time. Look. All right, I'm here with the crew of ISIS, and they are teaching me how to get ready for our actual parade. You're going to want to stay tuned. We're going to have all the details coming up. The crews are loading up dozens of voting machines ahead of Election Day. What's on tap is going to be loading all of these up. They're going to head over to the precincts. They're going to get all of these machines ready to go for voters. They're going to run through a test, and then they're going to lock them up for the night for safekeeping. Take a walk with me over to the BAM monitor, and I'll show you what
I see
talking
what you did
about.
There.
So you'll get good food and maybe even a selfie with Emeril Lagasse. After his namesake restaurant sat dark for more than a year, they are firing up the ovens again. We had the chance to talk with Emeril about reopening, the struggles that his team faced during the pandemic, and why he's still hoping that New Orleans will prevail.
It feels great. You know, it feels good with the staff. I think the staff is ready.
Those who step up to fight for our nation and for our country are brave. A majority of them are men, but it takes a fierce female to be a leader. In today's Veterans Voices, we want to introduce you to a pilot who was inspired by the women who paved the way for her.
The conditions are quickly changing. As you can see, the rain has started and the wind is greatly picking up. Like Scott just mentioned, we are expecting Hurricane Ida to hit us at a Category 4, if not worse.
Right now, we're over on Norco Elementary School's campus, and you can see all of these pine trees that are now draping across this campus. That's going to cause an issue as...
It was so nice to take a bath. That felt so good. Something that you just, you know, you don't think about when you have it all.
This is Surgeon Adams Jr. He has owned and operated his small business along the bayou for 60 plus years. Surviving several storms before, he says this one was brutal, and the days after the storm so far are even worse.
It all started as a police chase over in Gretna and ended at the foot of the expressway with a fiery crash. We do know that two suspects have been apprehended.
Whew, an excessive heat forecast is to be expected this week. We're talking about temps outside feeling like it's 110 degrees or higher.
All of these folks behind me are digging their own sandbags, getting ready to prepare their homes.
Karen Carter-Peterson said that she's feeling good about where she's at in the running and about what her campaign platform has stood for.
Many of you at home are probably wondering why I'm reporting live from the sewage and water turbine in Orleans Parish. Well, on President Biden's agenda is a proposal for an infrastructure plan.
2 weeks ago, this neighborhood was several feet underwater, all because of Hurricane Ida. And now with Nicholas making landfall, this area is under a flash flood watch. That means more water and more damage.
Tuesday, January 18th. So all of you fighting Wildcats who are out there, mark your calendars. That's the day that you're going to head back to class for school to be back in session. It's been 142 days since students have been on this campus. Destrehan High School students have been having to share a campus with Hanville High School, but not for much longer.
In you're off the float. Back in the float's dead. Morning.
Yes, good morning. I am in the float den and I am with the crew of ISIS, and they have
100 members who are going to be riding on some of these floats. They have 17 floats and they have thousands of throws. Look at that. It is official. Today is King's Day, and that means that we are kicking off Mardi Gras season 2022. And kicking it off right, we are inside of Mardi Gras World, surrounded by all of the floats that are soon going to be parading down the streets of New Orleans.